I don't know. Well, I think we're on.
We're live?
I think so. I just got the, it's hard to hear in here.
Some technical problems.
The cell service, you know, it's sometimes a little bit shaky when you're in at the stadium, but we welcome you into Memorial Stadium. What's going on, everybody? Are you fired up for senior night?
I am. We just saw Jalen Hurts and Grant Calcaterra, who unfortunately had to call it a career, just walk for senior night. Big ovations for both. It's the last home game here in Norman, so people are fired up for another night game.
I'm fired up for a night game, man. This is, you know, I love the atmosphere here in Norman as we get ready for OU and TCU. You know, it's got to be emotional for all those guys down there. How do you think this sucker plays out? I mean, I think I've been kind of the one guy maybe in the entire market on the limb that I think this has a chance to be a tough game for Oklahoma after the way they came back a week ago. TCU is really good against the run. We'll see how efficiently OU can throw the football. But for me, I think this is a competitive game. I think TCU's defense can cause OU some trouble.
Yeah, I mean, Gary Patterson, we all know what he can bring to the table defensively, and TCU is a good defense. So, and one thing that's kept OU in trouble the last 2 weeks against Iowa State and Baylor is turnovers.
It's true.
And Jalen Hurts has been throwing it up for grabs the last 2 weeks. So if they do that here tonight, absolutely. And I think the Vegas sharps agree with you. This line opened at 19. It has dropped to 17 today. Yeah. It dropped a lot today. So that means a lot of smart money came in late on TCU, which means a lot of the people that follow this for a living agree with you and think this will be a much closer game than probably most people think.
Fire off some questions here. We'll do our best to answer. We got about 20 minutes to kick off, so for the next 10, 15 minutes, we'll try to answer some questions. Somebody asked me if I'm growing a mullet like Gundy. I don't think so.
Growing the hair out.
I'm growing the hair out a little bit. You know, it's like
I am too, a little bit.
It's a winter do, you know? It's a winter.
Mine's a little longer than normal, too.
I love it. All right.
Are you hating on the lettuce?
That's okay. Hey, man, you know, it's all right. If you want to come after my lettuce, I got no problem with that. all right, for Oklahoma, they get out of here. What do you think they have to do probably better than they did a week ago? And we still don't know about CeeDee Lamb. We think he's going to play? I mean, I don't know.
I tell you, the CeeDee Lamb is a curious case. No one knows what's going on.
Yeah.
And Lincoln Riley called it a medical issue, but he warmed up in full pads. So if it's a concussion, he's not going to put on a helmet and look up in the bright lights for return punts and warm-ups.
Yeah.
If it was a knee, he wouldn't be moving around full speed like he was. We have no idea what's wrong with CeeDee Lamb, or if anything's wrong with him. Maybe he was suspended. We have no idea.
No idea.
The lack of transparency on this leads us to just wildly speculate. No one really knows what's happening. I expect him to play, but I don't have any certainty on that. So what Oklahoma needs to do, Brian, is pretty simple. They were up by 21 points against Iowa State three separate occasions, and they almost lost that football game. When they get up in this game, you can't turn it over, you can't have careless mistakes, and give TCU good field position. Because TCU is not an offense in which they're going to get the ball on the 20 and go 80 yards constantly. That's just not going to happen. They're going to need turnovers. They're going to need to flip the field with special teams. So when Oklahoma gets up, you got to keep the pedal to the metal. I think at times, Lincoln Riley, when he gets a lead, tends to coast a little bit. And I think that got him in trouble against Iowa State. He had the pedal to the metal in the second half against Baylor because he had to just to win the game. So I think that's the key for me.
Yeah, I mean, what they did against Baylor with such effectiveness is that they just ran the ball with Jalen Hurts, and they ran it right down Baylor's throat, and they couldn't do anything about it. That's why I think this is more a competitive game, because I don't know that you can just do that against TCU. I don't think you can just line up and pound them the way that they did against Baylor. So we'll see. They're going to have to be more efficient in the passing game. That's why CeeDee Lamb makes such a difference tonight. Especially big plays, because they can big play the heck out of you with CeeDee Lamb. He can score every time he touches the football, so it'll be interesting. Got an interesting question. It's not about the game today, but kind of moving forward. Will OU be better next year with Rattler, Weiss, Hazelwood, Bridges, and Stogner? I mean, they're pretty good right now.
Yeah.
And their quarterback is likely to be a finalist for the Heisman Trophy. So I don't think you just want to wish that away with new blood. I'm not for that.
It speaks to the level in which Lincoln Riley has gotten to offensively. He's had two Heisman Trophy winning quarterbacks.
Right.
And he's had an NFL offensive line for the last three, 4 years. They don't have an NFL offensive line anymore besides Creed Humphrey. So that's been a big problem for them. They don't run the football nearly as effectively as they have in years past. But they're still the best offense in the country. So I'm not going to sit here and say their offense is going to be better or worse next year. It's still going to be the best in the country, in my opinion, because I like that they mentioned those freshmen. I was screaming in the first half at Lincoln to look, it's senior night. Nick Basquin and A.D. Miller have had long careers here. It's time to unleash the freshman. I said that before the game against Baylor. Theo Weiss proved it in the second half. He's making big plays.
Big plays.
Jaden Hazelwood, to me, earlier in the year, was looking like their number two receiver. He's kind of fallen back. Those guys are the future, and I expect them to play a lot here tonight.
And the Stogner part of that is interesting. And starting last week, he had a couple of touchdowns. And I mentioned on the postgame show, he only had three catches this season. Two of them were touchdowns last week.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, he's going to be a big deal, especially when you consider the Calcaterra is not going to play ever again. I mean, I expect him to be a big weapon for Oklahoma, especially the way that they can run the ball. He's a huge weapon in the red zone. He proved it last week. So I expect both of those guys to all of those guys to continue the rest of the season and have big nights.
And what Jalen Hurts did so well in the second half against Baylor was he spread it around. Without CeeDee Lamb, he realized, I need to just make proper reads and spread the ball. He threw to 10 different receivers against Baylor, which it had to be more methodical because they didn't have the big plays of CeeDee Lamb. I think they had four touchdown drives of 12 plays, which tells you just how methodical they were. So if CeeDee Lamb can't go here tonight, I expect more of that. I expect him to spread it around to Lee Morris, who had a big game. So that was impressive for Jalen Hurts. He proved that he doesn't have to just rely on CeeDee Lamb.
Can their defense? I mean, TCU's not a great offense. Their defense needs to come out tonight and make some plays. They made just enough a week ago, and really the turnover.
Just a shutout in the second half.
No, absolutely. The turnover in the third quarter made all the difference. That was a change of the game. And so I want to see OU's defense to play much better tonight against an offense that's not terribly explosive and hasn't been for most of the season. I mean, think TCU and Baylor went to overtime. I think it was, 9-9. I mean, I want to see Oklahoma's defense play like that.
Well, here's where I'm at with OU's defense. If you had told me before the year they'd be top 50 in the country, you would have taken that without blinking.
Right.
And their defense, to me, by the metrics, has improved just as much, if not more so, than LSU's offense, which everyone in the country keeps talking about how much better LSU is on offense.
They are.
But no one's talking about how much better OU is on defense. Now, are they back to playing, you know, Rocky Kalmus-style defense? No. But they're way better than they were last year. So, and I thought they played really well at times. They pitched a shutout against Baylor in the second half. And let's face it, Jalen Hurts put them in horrible positions to where the defense really didn't have much of a chance to stop them in the first half. Same with Iowa State. CeeDee Lamb turns it over on their own in their own territory. Jalen Hurts turns it over in their own territory. That's 14 points right there. I mean, so now could they have gotten stopped? Sure. I'm not absolving the OU defense, but they have gotten better this year. And I think they're capable of really giving Max Duggan, the freshman quarterback from TCU, a lot of problems because he can turn the ball over with the best of them, as OSU proved against him.
Does emotion in a senior night situation play any role as far as these kinds of games go?
Sure. I mean, not only are your parents here, your whole family's the most
likely
here.
Yeah,
a lot
no
more
doubt.
People that come to watch you play. So I think initially, yes, but once the game starts, I think that goes by the wayside. You're just trying to do your job and make plays. But it is the last home game. OU's, I think more than anything, Brian, I think they might want it a little too much in terms of a big win to prove something to the playoff committee, because it's only human nature. You keep seeing them not improving in the college football rankings behind teams that, frankly, don't have as many quality wins as Oklahoma. I think that could probably play in their heads more than senior night.
It's a beautiful night. I mean, you can't beat this.
I packed like way more clothes than I needed. It's not that bad.
No, I totally agree with that. You're picking Oklahoma, and you're picking a big, right?
I'm picking them to cover. You know, the line's down to 17.5. I'm picking them by 21. I just think I've seen too many games here in Norman, and even I keep going back to the Iowa State game. Like, they led by three different occasions
by 21
points and just kind of sat on the ball in the second half and let Iowa State back in it. I don't think they'll do that here. Lincoln knows he needs style points, I think, most importantly. He won't ever admit that, but he wants to win by as many points as possible tonight.
All right, we're about to get to the national anthem. Because of that, we're going to let everybody go, and we're going to honor America. All right,
see
we'll see you later.
Game.